Okay, we're here with Cloud Shifter's Blade by King Bubble. We're gonna get a new game. Just playing through this since Microsoft will be killing Project Spark in a couple of days, and want to make sure that we have some record of how this game works. You should be able to still play it on your computer. Playing on a computer right now. There's one controller bug, and you have to go to Project Spark CH to figure out I guess it's Project Spark. So the bug here, you have to get the focus somewhere else. And get preview window on the bottom, and then the controller will start working. Right trigger and see the same point. First though, I want to get my weapon. Thank you. I'm gonna have to fight Rager. Bosses in this game are pretty good. Gregor here is basically...
Thank you. to hurt. Don't be sore, loser.
Okay, we're back. Cloud shifting over here. Oh, this is very important. Whenever you come back, you need to pick your weapons up. And then try to use both of them. This is just a little bug in how Project Spark handles things. It didn't let me really send people through to both save and resume the games. So. Alright, next we're gonna try this. Badge. So you see we've got four balls and four fires. Blue and red. So we have to use the blue balls to knock out the blue fires. The red balls knock out the red fires. We like to jump down. A little bit hard to see when there's smoke. Okay, so now the smoke is dissipating from that one. And I gotta do this on all four of them. This button over here is a reset button. In case something goes wrong and one of the balls goes in the wrong color, it'll let us start over. Hopefully we won't have to use this. So every time one of the fires goes out, couple enemies come. There's a guy who dropped bombs on the top, and the other guy. Usually he comes down, but. Let's take a look again. Red ball. We need to go to the right. It doesn't go exactly in, but as long as it hits the fire, it will put it out. Again, these platforms are bouncing up. One of the more challenging ones. You can take a hint from two lives. And that means he's told us the pattern, but there's going to be two mistakes. So, whether to take it because it filled up my aura, which I didn't need, but it's alright. So now we see that one. Actually not bad to fight you guys here. Some experience. I really want to try to get up to level 6 before I face Cypher. You can see on the aura power, I only have 2. Oh, actually, yeah, level 6 I become invulnerable, and the aura burst doesn't come to level 7. Aura burst is really going to help me against Cypher, the boss of level 3. Okay, so I'm still here. Maze was one of the most difficult trophies to get before I changed it so they disappeared. I believe. Yep. Trophy. So, I've got it. Now, I'm gonna come up here. To the Wrath Trophy. My daughter wants to play, but she doesn't know I'm recording this. So,
here, you get to play again later.
Project Spark, Cloud Shifters, and we have under here the Cloud Chess Club. So Cloud Chess is actually a real game. We've got plans. You can 3D print all the extra pieces, similar to regular chess. Here are the rules. Instead, you can promote your pieces. Instead of promoting to queens, you can promote to winged pieces. And we have 2 extra pieces, a wrath and a archer. So this is a really fun game. I recommend you guys go to candypuddle.com and check it out. I should be strong enough to get these guys now. 10 wrath eggs. Nice helpful counter. These are kind of hard to find. So you go up, press B, and unfortunately, wraths come out. Not too hard to kill with a few shots from the bow, however. You don't have to kill each wrath, you just have to open the egg, but they can fly, so you really don't want 10 of these guys chasing you around. Especially when it's not too hard. Just to kill them with the bow. Thank you. 2 levels to this maze. So because we can't fly, we can swim up top here. That'll help us. More A. Good to keep your coins up as much as you can. We need to jump. Okay. So we're back now. As you can see, there are weapons. We've got 6 trophies, so we need to go ahead and get 2 more trophies, fight the dragon, and then we can get our wings and get to level 3. Now we're gonna come here under the lake and take that last one we missed before, where they recommended we be at least on level 3. Good now. Knock it back. Nice. Level up. I'm gonna run over here now. The last trophy I need is the cloud wheel, but I want to get a little more experience before I go. Yeah, this is a way to hit a lot of enemies fairly quickly. Also, side gate is the same enemies as before, but they are much bigger. Unfortunately, it doesn't explode when you go up there. Right? You can see the cloud wheel over there. I have to head next. Turn on the fans. If you make it without any rescues, you're able to fight Riker, the monster arena. He won't fight you if you've been rescued before. parts of the game. Real easy if I have my wings. Could buy a Buka shot or hell shot, but I think I'll save that for an upgraded bow. And your wings. Not a moment too soon. Tiberius is headed to your village. Now the right button will let you fly. And you can now fly over and see what we got. I'm gonna come back down here. See, my hit points are my experience points are close to a new level. I definitely want to pass before going to level 3. Fight in 3 dimensions. Throw it out. Let go of the right one. still die by falling. Sure, you don't do that. I'm gonna go over to that wing section. The place we weren't able to go to before. This is the weapons, so we can see here, still on student sword, so got a little ways to go. I thought there was a shot around here. See it. It should have been on a little table. That's alright. We are gonna head back to the gate. Get to level 3. Okay, so we're back. Level 3 here. We've got Gurr, our dragon, who's gonna follow us around. Shoot fireballs at anyone who attacks us. Now, unfortunately, my game just crashed. I came to level 3 and I fought Riker, and I earned the Aura Burst Sword for defeating him. And I was able to do that because I came here with no rescues. You can see I did die a couple times against Riker. It's alright though. He still appeared and I got the Aura Burst Sword. Next, I'm gonna come here and I'm going to buy the enchanted bow. I'm gonna get out of here. Aura Burst Sword. It's great. It's a super powerful weapon. It not only is its damage good, it will actually damage and push away everything else on the screen. This is by far the most powerful weapon in the game. Not easy to get, but now that I got it, I'm very happy to have it. So again, this is the monster arena. I'm gonna take a regular match. Or power of our sword to make short work of these opponents. I'm gonna need to do this a couple times in order to get my level back up. To reset this monster arena, I'm just gonna come over here and save. Which is just gonna drop me out of the level and come back. Fortunately, that's a bug where the monsters think they can fly when they can't. But. Pretty simple bug to work around. Like another error in the monster in the code for the case where you try to go back after you've already fought Riker. Good idea to make sure both of your weapons work after you pick them up again. Unfortunately, a limit of Project Spark. There we go. Take the regular match. Like me too. sometimes you can get into a situation in this game where you really need your hit points up. But how to do that without this level? Now I've got the regen shield, so whenever I get hit, I get some extra back. Got the upgraded bow, the best bow, the regen shield, the best shield, and the arbor sword, best sword. Now it's time to face Cypher. True power. So when he's like this, he is invulnerable. Hidden. However, when I hit him, I destroy the flying units. Get a little time to hit him. Grow invulnerable again. See? So now, we've got these two balls flying around. One of the things you can do is fly away from him, let him come, and then try to hit those balls as he gets closer. He runs faster than the balls do. Around. The gin stones make him invulnerable. Pretty difficult. Now my arbor sword hits them when I'm on. Gurr can also start working on the gin stone. Oh, we see him running around. You see those red. There they are. Tiberius was right. He will be anxious to meet you. Now that Cypher is defeated, we can head through this portal and head to level 4. Okay, here I am on level 4. Not sure why. Get my controller back. So, this portal in level 4 will let me either save or go to level 3. Yeah. Over here we have Instructor Cade. Tell him I'm stuck, the teleporters keep changing colors and the guardians push you away. If you go close to a teleporter, you can activate it. The guardians will come out, and the outer ring color is which teleporter this is. The inner ring color is where it goes. Since here we went to, the strong enemies here who also will heal themselves. Fortunately, or a burst sword really helps out. So, we're here in the jail. This is actually the respawn point to die during this level. You go out the back of the jail here. We'll find the flame sword on top of here. It's the second most powerful sword. I'm not gonna take it because they already have the Arbor sword. But if you ever died in the game at any time, even until you faced Riker, you wouldn't be able to get the Arbor sword. So for most people, that flame sword is gonna be nice. So I'm done here. I'm gonna activate this transporter again. Blue was where we came from. Those guys push you away. Oh, but we still made it. This is now the pink one. Or yellow. Got training going on here. Heard that intruder. Come on, right, that paranoid group is just messing up. They might be the only one. Guys are hard at work training. Okay. Archery. So these eyeballs, if they see us, they will take us back to the jail. If we can sneak through without being noticed. Got it. He will take us to, Tiberius. Two eyeballs. Rogue Jin Master, he says, watch out for Tiberius' Jin. You need to stop the skulls. advice. Went to yellow. Good. So I'm back to the main area. Enemies that have built up. I could always go back to 605, so could always go back and could always go back to level 3 by a booster shot. Try to save up my my money so I can fight Ariana. Now that I'm on level 8, I've also got the level 2 heal. Well, help. I'm also gonna try this vulnerability boost again. It's impossible to hit me. Still not coming back correctly. Let's save the progress and come back.
Oh,
spawning is random, so you never know when they're gonna come out. Now we are with Arbor, so you can take guys on the ground, they're all dead. Tiberius. There's three things going on in this battle. There's Tiberius himself, who's pretty fast if he keeps hitting you. There's the djinn spawning skulls, and there's the djinn. There's two djinn spawning skulls on either side. You can see if you hit them. Try to hit them. They're vulnerable before the battle starts. They're gonna send out various Cloudstone Djinns, which will do things like make Tiberius vulnerable, heal him, poison you, light you on fire, and so on. Try to make sure I live. Well, go ahead here. Get out of hand very quickly. Hope you guys enjoyed Cloud Shifters. I should mention the last beating Tiberius will not save your game, so you can keep going back and playing from there. You can go back to level 3 and try to get some of the monster battles you haven't gotten, or keep getting stronger. Thanks, hope you enjoyed it.